Hey, Phil from Mux here. We build video infrastructure that any developer can leverage to build amazing video experiences on their website. I'm here with a quick demo of how you can use one of our new features, latest thumbnails, to analyze and moderate the content that's coming from your live streams using AI. Let's take a look. We're going to need three things to build this out. First of all, we're going to need a live stream. We're going to need an account and some API keys for OpenAI's API. And then we're just going to need a little node strip to glue it all together. We've got our live stream up and running in OBS. At the moment, this is just showing Big Book Bunny, which is, of course, the best movie ever made. But what if somebody started streaming something that wasn't Big Book Bunny? What if they streamed a violent movie or something even worse? Let's hook up some content moderation so that if or when that happens, we can catch it. Mux has always had an image API. This lets you pull thumbnails or storyboards or animated GIFs from videos or live streams. We added a new feature a couple of weeks ago, which allows you to request the latest thumbnail from a live stream. All you need to do is build your image URL the same way you always would, but pass a new query parameter called latest and set it to true. This works just like it always has done, but by adding the latest parameter, this means that every 10 seconds, this thumbnail will get updated with the latest thumbnail from a live stream. This is great because it means you can pretty much just pass this straight into any old moderation framework you have. Doesn't matter whether that's OpenAI's, it doesn't matter whether that's Hive's or somebody else's. Just having this constant URL you can use to always get that live image just means that updating your moderation flow is just as simple as adding a new job to your moderation queue. So for this example, we're going to use OpenAI's moderation model. What's really cool about this API is it's actually free. There are rate limits, so if you're building something significant in scale, you might want to keep that in mind. We're going to use OpenAI's latest Omni moderation model. This can take and moderate either text or images. And obviously, we're using it in the image mode because we're going to pass it this latest thumbnail from our live stream. Okay, so let's take a look at the code. This whole script is less than 50 lines of Node.js. First thing you need to do is just import the OpenAI SDK and then set up our API keys so we can access the OpenAI client. We've got a function, an async function, which just you pass in a playback ID and it moderates a live stream. The first thing this function does is construct the URL. It passes in a playback ID, obviously, and sets latest to true. And then it sets the width to 640 pixels wide. Obviously, we'll then automatically pick a height for it based on the aspect ratio of the content. 640 is a pretty good balance here. It's probably more than you actually need for moderation. But if you were then using this image for other functions like summarization or categorization, tagging, that sort of thing, you might want a little bit higher image quality, especially if you're using a multimodal LVM for this. Then we pretty much just call the OpenAI client. We tell it to use Omni moderation latest. That's the model we just talked about. We pass it the image URL, and that's kind of it. This is asynchronous, so we wait for this response, and then we take a look at response. There is a top-level Boolean that's whether this content was flagged or not. This is set to true if any of the categories come back over 80% confidence. We're looking at two categories here. We're looking at sexual, and we're looking at violence. So let's take a look and see if anyone has put anything sinister into our copy of Big Book Bunny. Okay, so we've got our moderation script running. It's pretty quiet right now. Every 15 seconds, this is requesting the latest frame of a live stream. That's updated every 10 seconds, so you always know that you're gonna get a new thumbnail this way. We can actually also turn up the frequency. We refresh those images, so if you need to be slightly more accurate, we can help you do that. There's not a whole lot going on here, so we're gonna just use a horror movie for this and see what happens in our script. Let's take a look. So now we've flipped over to watching a horror movie on our live stream, and you'll see that we're starting to get flags back for violence. So this is quite a gory horror movie, and you'll see that the violence value is coming back at 0.8, 0.9. What happens here is you get a confidence value from 0 to 1, where 1 is very high confidence that the model is seeing violence, and 0 is a very low confidence value. So we can see, for example, the sexual confidence is very low, which means the content probably isn't sexual. But yeah, it's quite violent. It's a horror movie. There are monsters doing unspeakable things to people. So we're correctly detecting that this movie is a bit violent. You can obviously see how if you're building out a user-generated content platform with a live streaming functionality, how this is really useful, how you can use this to catch streams that shouldn't be on your platform. What's really cool is this same approach works for a bunch of other functionality. I recently wrote a blog post about how you can also use these same latest thumbnails with multimodal models and prompts to do content summarization or content tagging, all through using the same latest thumbnail function. So not just for moderation, you can kind of string all sorts of AI workflows off the back of this. As always, I'd love to see what you build on top of latest thumbnails. You can use it to build all sorts. This is just one way of leveraging that feature. And if you want more tips and tricks and cool things built with video, don't forget to like and subscribe to our YouTube channel. But also go and check out mux.com, where you can play around with all this infrastructure. We've also got an amazing new free plan for getting started building with Mux, so check that out too.